First of all, I welcome you all for Edomerge classes. Here you can emerge through education. In this segment, I am going to discuss some of the important multiple choice questions related to the chapter Sexual Reproduction in Flowering Plants. The first question is, what is the fate of male gametes discharged in the synergid? The options are like this. This question is related to double fertilization concept. What happens during double fertilization is, in angiosperms during fertilization, the pollen tube carrying two male gametes enters into the ovule either through micropylar end or through chalazal end or even through the integuments. Micropylar end mukantra enter adre porogamy anta karitivi, chalazal end mukantra enter adre chalazogamy anta karitivi, integuments mukantra enter adre mesogamy anta karitivi. ನೋಡಿ, ಹೀಗೆ ಕೆ ಸಿ ಟಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಲವಾರು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರೀತಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಅರೈಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ನಾವು ಫೈನಲಿ ವಿತ್ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಲಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಪರೇಟರ್ಸ್ ಪೋಲನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈನರ್ಜಿಡ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಮೇಲ್ ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ದ ಡಿಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್. ಫಿಲಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಪರೇಟರ್ಸಿನ ಸಹಾಯದಿಂದ ಪೋಲನ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಎಂಬ್ರಿಯೋಸ್ಯಾಕ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಎರಡು ಸೈನರ್ಜಿಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಸೈನರ್ಜಿಡ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ಗೆ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. And it will going to release two male gametes. Now, out of the two male gametes, one male gamete fuses with haploid egg to form a diploid structure known as zygote. This zygote later develops into embryo. And another male gamete fuses with central cell nuclei or diploid secondary nucleus to form a triploid structure known as PEN. That is primary endosperm nucleus. This PEN later develops into endosperm. Hence, out of four options, the correct option is D. One fuses with egg and other fuses with central cell nuclei. Next, what is the ploidy of endothecium, microspore mother cell, microspore and vegetative cell? Here endothecium is a part of anther. We know that plant body is sporophyte, which is diploid in nature. Plant nalli reproductive structure yavadu andre flower. As plant is diploid, flower is also diploid. Flower nalli one part of stamen. Flower diploid agidmele stamen kuda diploid agirutte. Stamen nalli one part anther. Therefore anther is also diploid. Anther nalli one part of endothecium. As anther diploid, endothecium is also diploid. Next, microspore mother cell ploidy bandre, it is also diploid in nature. Because we know that during the formation of microspores, each sporogenous cell directly behaves as microspore mother cell. This sporogenous cell is also a part of anther. Hence, microspore mother cell ploidy is diploid. Next, microspore ploidy bandre, it is haploid in nature. Yake antandre, microspore is formed from microspore mother cell through meiosis. We know that after meiosis, chromosome number is reduced to half. Therefore, microspore is haploid in nature. Vegetative cell ploidy bandre, it is also haploid in nature. Yake antandre, vegetative cell is a part of microspore or pollen grain. As microspore is haploid, vegetative cell is also haploid. Therefore, the ploidy of endothecium, microspore mother cell, microspore and vegetative cell is 2N, 2N, N and N respectively. Hence, the correct option is C. Next, in flowering plants, Archisporium gives rise to. Here, four options are given: only tapetum and sporogenous cells, only the wall of the sporangium, both wall and sporogenous cells, wall and the tapetum. See, there is an outermost layer called epidermis. Just below the epidermis, hypodermal cells are present. During the development of anther, hypodermal cell becomes differentiated by the prominent nucleus and cytoplasm called archisporial cell or archisporial initial. This archisporial cell undergoes transverse division to produce primary parietal cell and a primary sporogenous cell. Primary parietal cell later gives rise to endothecium, middle layers and tapetum. These are all the anther wall layers. While the sporogenous cell directly behaves as pollen mother cell, This pollen mother cell undergoes meiosis to produce 4 haploid microspores. Therefore, archisporial cell gives both anther wall layers as well as sporogenous cells. Hagagi, C is the correct answer. Next question. Pollination by bat is called ornithophily, pollination by birds. Malacophily, pollination by snails. Myrmecophily, pollination by ants. Chiropterophily, pollination by bats. In addition to this, anemophily, pollination by wind, not by animals. Zoophily, pollination by animals. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆರಡರ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಡಿ. ಇಫ್ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ವಾಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಫಿಲಿ. ಇನ್ ಎ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ವೇ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಂಟಮೋಫಿಲಿ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಪಾಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಬೈ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೈರಪ್ಟರೋಫಿಲಿ. ಸೊ ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಆನ್ ಎಗ್ ಆಪರೇಟಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್. We know that a matured embryo sac is 7-celled and 8-nucleated. In an embryo sac, the 3 cells which are present towards gelosal end are called antipodal cells. Centrally, polar nuclei present agirutte. And the 3 cells present towards micropylar end, they are called egg operators. In egg operators, central one is called egg and other 2 cells are called synergids. Therefore, egg operators contains 1 egg and 2 synergids. Here C is the correct option. Next, fertilized secondary nucleus develops into. Here fertilized secondary nucleus is nothing but primary endosperm nucleus. We know that after fertilization, fruit is formed from ovary, embryo is formed from zygote, seed is formed from ovule, endosperm is formed from pen. Therefore, fertilized secondary nucleus develops into endosperm. Here D is the correct option. Next, which of the following plant has smallest pollen grain? In Mirabilis plant, largest pollen grain is present. In Zostera, longest pollen grain is present. In Calotropis, pollen grains are present in a sac-like structure known as pollinia. In Myosotis, smallest pollen grain is present and it measures about 6 micrometer in diameter. Hagagi, option A is correct. Next, a typical anther is. We know that in a flower, the male reproductive organ is stamen. Stamen has got 2 parts, namely upper anther and a basal filament. Anther is bilobed. In each lobe, 2 pollen sacs are present. In a bilobed anther, 4 pollen sacs are present. Pollen sac ge microsporangium antanu kuda karitivi. So bilobed anther contains 4 pollen sacs or 4 microsporangia. Therefore, bilobed anther is always tetrasporangiate because it has 4 microsporangia. Next, atechnic ovule is found in. In Aspodilus, ovule is tritegmic. In Cynopodium, it is bitegmic. In Juglans, it is unitegmic. But in Volax, it has no integuments. Therefore, atechnic ovule is found in Volax plant. Here, option C is correct. Next, what is the cotyledon of maize embryo called? Maize is a monocot. In monocots, single cotyledon is called scutellum. So B is the correct option. Hagadre, what about epiblast? Epiblast is the rudimentary cotyledon found in dicot embryo. Plumule mate radical ig bandre, both are embryonal axis parts. Here plumule gives rise to shoot, radical gives rise to root. Next question. A non-nutritive structure is option A tapetum, option B endosperm, option C integument, option D palisade parenchyma. Here tapetum is a nutritive tissue which provide nourishment for developing pollen grains. Endosperm is also a nutritive tissue which provide nourishment for developing embryo. Palisade parenchyma is found in the leaves of plants. It is also nutritive in function. But integument is a part of ovule and it is a protective covering. It doesn't provide any nourishment. Therefore, integument is the correct option. In hemianotropous ovule, the micropyle and chalaza are. We know that based on the position of micropyle and chalaza with respect to funicle, ovule is classified into six types. They are orthotropous ovule, anatropous ovule, hemianotropous ovule, campylotropous ovule, amphitropous ovule, and sarcinotropous ovule. In orthotropous ovule, micropyle, chalaza, and funicle, they are present in a straight line. In anatropous ovule, micropyle and chalaza, they are lie in a straight line, but not the funicle. In hemianotropous ovule, micropyle and chalaza are situated right angles to the funicle. In campylotropous ovule, body of the ovule is curved, but embryo sac remains straight. In amphitropous ovule, both ovule body as well as embryo sac is curved. In sarcinotropous ovule, ovule turns to more than 360 degree, hence funicle becomes coil around the ovule. Here in this question, hemianotropous ovule nalli yenagirutte anta keliyare. In hemianotropous ovule, micropyle and chalaza are placed right angles to the funicle. Therefore, B is the correct option. Next, endosperm cell of an angiosperm has 24 chromosomes. The number of chromosomes in the gametes would be. We know that endosperm is a triploid tissue. Its ploidy is 3N. In gametes, ploidy is haploid. Here 3N is equal to 24. Endosperm nalli chromosomes number eshtide 24. Hagadre gametes nalli chromosome number eshtirutte ano question keliyare. Then N is equal to 24 by 3, 3 ones are, 3 eights are, therefore N is equal to 8. Option A is correct. Next, what is the function of filiform apparatus? It brings about opening of pollen tube. It is the wrong statement. It guides pollen tube from synergy to egg. It is also a wrong option. It helps in guiding the entry of pollen tube into synergid. This is the correct statement. It prevents entry of more than one pollen tube into the embryo sac. It is also wrong. Here, option C is correct. Next, polygonum type of embryo sac is 8 nucleate 3 celled embryo sac is called Plumbagella type of embryo sac. 4 nucleate 4 celled embryo sac is called Oinothera type of embryo sac. 16 nucleate 9 celled embryo sac is called Peperomia type of embryo sac. 8 nucleate 7 celled embryo sac is called Polygonum type of embryo sac, because It was first studied in polygonum plant by Strasburger. Strasburger antakantaha scientist polygonum plant nalli 8 nucleate 7 celled embryo sac na moddu study martare. Hagagi 8 nucleate 7 celled embryo sac ge polygonum type of embryo sac anta karithivi.